Hello candidates, welcome to mcqforall.com. I am your host Amit. In this video, I am going to take you over the recent CAT syllabus change and how it's going to impact you and what does it really mean. So in 2015 CAT, this quite a bunch of changes happened against the recent 2014 CAT, and so getting started with it. So here is the syllabus. First of all, you can see like the exam pattern. Okay, so quantitative 34, verbal ability, reading comprehension 34, and data interpretation logical reasoning 32. So in all, you all know that the number of sections got increased, all right, and the number of questions also got changed. But in exact way, what exactly it is like this. So in first of all, the timing got changed. Now the CAT exam will be a 180 minutes, and earlier it used to be a 170 minutes. So there will be 10 minutes for you. So how is going to impact you? All the entrance exam which happens across India, if I talk about except GATE and UGC, all the exams happens in 120 minute period, and so 170 quite lengthy, and 180 again lengthy. So it's test of your patience and test of your concentration and test of your resilience, how much resilient you are when you approach towards an exam and keep yourself same level throughout that 180 minutes. So again it's good for you. Anything more is good when in terms of timing. So you'll have more time, and it's always good for you when you utilize in a good way. Okay, second change is like now we have three sections in place of two sections. Earlier it used to be two section, now we have three sections with the division of questions of 34, 34 and 32. So quantitative now become only one section, VNRC 34 and DINLR 32. It used to be the same pattern 3 years back. In last 2 to 3 years, lots of changes, but again CAT is on same pattern where QA wholesome is 34. Logically, VA and RC, verbal ability and reading comprehension, they have in combined both and gave it as a single section 34, DI and LR 32. So how going to impact you? So first of all, it's a good division, because logically saying DI and LR into same section makes sense, quantitative in a different section makes sense, and VA and RC always makes sense. So earlier it was a bunch of QA and DI, all these were good, two sections were good, but still the aptitude required to solve a certain kind of question always helpful when same kind of questions comes in a chunk. Okay, so first of all, it's going to be helpful from psychological point of view. Second, looks like my video, where should I keep, let me keep it here, so that, so it will be have three sections, then every section will be predefined order, and will have allotted time, and this is, okay, so, every section will be allotted of 60 minutes each, okay, and you cannot jump among the sections, and you have to give that section its due timing, and the sequence will be strictly in the same way. You cannot change. Usually what happens is like when we talk about the entrance exams, we get the series, and that in the paper series the questions are jumbled up, but into this it will not be like that. Sections will be common for all serial wise, and then you'll have the time allotted to a particular section with 60 minutes, and you have to give that 60 minutes to that. Alright, so how is going to impact you? First of all, from engineering candidates who used to have a good inclination towards quantitative, and then used to solve quantitative faster, and then used to jump over VA and RC, and so no more this kind of jumping will be allowed. And it is like CAT board have decided to, you know, give the importance to every background, and they want the even candidates coming from each background. So as of now, it's like candidates from engineering background or candidates from any science or mathematical background used to get a lot of appreciation into this kind of exam where you have no. But if you're not from engineering background or any mathematical, you know, inclination, even then you'll have a very fair amount of chances that you may get the same level of output from the same exam as somebody from the another mathematical background candidate will get. So first is this. Second is like it is always important not to rush into any exam, because with this mock series, all these tests happens across the coaching centers. You know, candidate get used to of it, like do one thing first and then jump on second and then jump on third and then coming back, and then these all things make everything jumbled up, and ultimately it loses your concentration, it loses everything which you would have done well if you have concentrated well on one section then moving to the another section. So in that both sense it is going to be benefited to you, and just try to prepare in a way like every section has their own importance, and you cannot give a level of importance before coming to the exam. Now then written answers will be introduced into this. Now this is a new addition of it, and in fact a very good decision by CAT board. Is like there happens used to be the GMAT and GRE exam where written answers all out. Like CAT is all about objective questions, objective answers, and then in our terms like tukka, you know, sometimes when you get goofed up, so then you select and which can be the right one, right? So this will not be allowed, and this will not be entertained anymore when the written questions answer will be there. So out of those 35-34 questions, at least how many questions will come into that, and in what sense it will come, like either you have to write the answer or you have to write the option ABCD, it is still not clear. So only when the CAT mock will available in October month, then anybody can say in what way this written answers will be introduced. Till that time, we can only say like it is good, because less bluffing and more accurate and more testing of your overall grip over the subject and the level of preparation. Then moving to the next is like test will be held at 650 centers across 136 cities in November 20th. Yes, earlier it used to be happen is like CAT exam, of course the number of candidates are very high, so they used to conduct in a number of days across different locations and sometime in a different time period too. So always one center or one day before that anybody have already given the test will have their own presumption of their own test, right? So the candidates coming for the next session will have something to ask, how was your test, and what was your reaction, what should be this, what should that. This all make a nonsense around the test scenario, and people asking, blabbing, and getting confused before going to their own exam. So CAT board have understood this, and they have done. It's now like everybody will be on the same time, same day, one day, and everything will be finished for that particular day. That's it. So it is good. First, it will remove the confusion. Second, it will help you to prepare well when you are less confused, and to concentrate well when you know that it is one day and that is the D day for you. If you do well, that's good. If you do not do well, then leave for the next year. Then test will be going to the next, candidate can select four cities in order of preference. Allotment of session will be random. Okay, so though it is on same day, but session will be different, and then four options will be given to select your. So how good or bad, I mean, we cannot say, but one thing is sure, that once the notification is out, better you select and fill the form as soon as possible, because the options are limited, right? And every center have their limited number of seats. So the famous locations like Delhi, Chennai, Bangalore, all those cosmopolitan cities where the candidates, the universities are number of high, the candidates are high, will be filled up soon, right? And then the second tier cities will come, and then the third tier cities. Though the chances are like the exams will happen on first tier and second tier cities itself. So better you select your nearest possible location as soon as possible before somebody else will come and grab it for himself. And then the last is, tutorial will be to understand new exam format will be available on CAT from October 15. So November 29 is the date for exam, October 15, around 15-40 days before the exam, you'll have the mock kind of a test from the CAT to understand how it really looks like. So earlier it used to be around 1 month back, 1 month before that. So little more time is given for candidate to understand, to cope up with the news pattern. So overall, the new changes which CAT is coming up with 2015 is good when compared to the previous CAT. And all the chances which I can presume from these changes are like, the board of CAT have decided to make this test as normalized as possible, in spite of giving the more variance and giving the more confusion and giving the more chances for candidate to get goofed up. So prepare well, and we at MCQ for all, since we have already told, like, this, all the information which I have included here is already there on the our website, which is mcqforall.com, which you can always refer it. So here is the website, okay, and here is the CAT Z preparation, and here is the same syllabus which I have covered there. So come here and see changes and all these things. Same things I have uploaded on the presentation and shown to you. So you are welcome to prepare here. And as mentioned, like, we are going to start the live test preparation from 2nd of September 2015, and it will go till 28th of November 2015. So come and prepare lively, and compare yourself with the other candidates, and get benefited out of it, because it's a competitive examination, right? You have to compete it. You cannot run away from competition, and there is no better way comparing with yourself as much as possible with others, and getting to know how exactly it's going to benefit you. Okay, so when you know what your competitor is doing, where he is doing good, and where you are lacking, then only you'll be able to know where you have to improve it. Otherwise, your preparation will always be a preparation in the corner of your home, and chances are that you may lose for 1 mark or 2 marks, but you may also benefit from that 1 mark or 2 marks if you are prepared well along with others. That's all for this session. In the next session, we will cover the new topics for CAT 2015 preparation. Bye-bye for now, and do subscribe to our YouTube channel, because we will cover everything through video, and this video will upload on YouTube, and you should get notified once it get uploaded, so that your preparation will always be on your toe, and your preparation will always be benefited for you in spite of, you know, getting lagged during this whole process. Bye bye for now.